Sir, don't tell me about laws. I'll tell you what. Sir, I'll tell you. You want me to say it directly? Before Ami Agnik comes in, I want to make a point to you. Sir, don't forget. You can't take a hands off. I will keep pushing you on this case. You know why? Because you look at your own background. In 2012, this previous special public prosecutor, B.V. Acharya, had quit in this case. August 2012. After alleging that the then BJP government in Karnataka tried to get him removed in an attempt to woo the AIADMK. So you have mixed up your so-called fight against corruption with an issue of political convenience. You are going soft on Jayalalitha and an issue of corruption because you don't know when on earth you are going to need her. And for you, political convenience is more important.
Arnav, what makes you think?
You need her in the Rajya Sabha.
You
need her to get your bills passed in the Rajya Sabha. You need her to function in parliament. And therefore, your hands are tied. You can't even speak out today, Mr. Narasimha Rao. Do you realize how bad this is looking for you?
No, absolutely not. I'm saying the court conviction has already happened.
So you are
in jail.
See, there's no role. The court conviction is okay, but you lack conviction today.
Legal remedy.
Mr. Rao, why are you lacking conviction?
She can try and get the
conviction. Why are you lacking conviction?
Where on earth does the central government come in?
Why are you lacking conviction, Mr. Rao? Why is your voice shaking? Ami Agnik is coming into the debate. Ami Agnik, please. Ami Agnik.
We are not dependent on anybody.
Ami Agnik, please. Ami Agnik, we are watching you, sir. The same conviction with which you spoke of Kani Modi and Raja is missing in the case of Jayalalitha. Yes, Ami Agnik.
There are two distinct issues here, Arnav. One is about the criminal justice system and the law. It says 3 points, that nobody is above the law. There might be a delay of 18 years, but the delays ultimately get justice in our system. And the third is that there are numerous cases pending in several courts of our country. I think they'll take a cue from this, that there is a precedent here and that corruption cannot be taken lightly. So here, these are the issues about the justice system, and the judgment is definitely welcome. Of course, the convict is having a lot of avenues open to go for appeal in a higher forum for bail, and several other provisions are there in the criminal procedure code also.
No, that's all right. But didn't Subramaniam Swami host a tea party with Sonia Gandhi and Jayalalitha in 1999? So what are you talking about?
Oh, that was long.
You have also
that
compromised.
Was long back.
Oh, long back. So
not,
I shouldn't talk about.
And we may not talk about. No,
why should
Arnav,
I not talk about
Arnav,
it? Because
we may not
it's long
talk
back.
About.
I am
no,
raising
no,
this
not,
as a case in
We may
in
not
point.
Talk about. We may not talk about Subramaniam Swami. The
why not?
Can
why
be
not? Did he not bring Sonia Gandhi and Jayalalitha together in 1999? Was this case not on then? What the FIRs not being filed? Did you not know about the charges in 2009? Did you not know about the disproportionate charges cases in 1999? You knew about it. You didn't care. No, because 1999 you thought ye sab chalta hai. You had a chalta hai attitude on issues of corruption. Why should I not talk about 1999? Ami Agnik, please tell me. Why should I not talk? Why should I not talk about the Tea Party?
You can talk about... No, you can talk about it. It is history. It is a matter of record. But that is not going
it's
to come
contemporary
in
history,
the way
not
of the judgment right now we are talking. It happens in politics. 1999 something is different today.
So
the BJP is wooing Jayalalitha ji. And that is why they are silent. In political convenience, that's the word you use. We have a classic example in Gujarat. The minister is sitting in the cabinet, Babu Bokharia. He is also involved in an illegal mining scam,
on,
which is again a human rights violation if you look at it. He has ruined the natural resources of Gujarat, and still BJP has not removed the cabinet minister.
Come on,
and so let us
I
look at the political convenience.
How your party,
sir,
how
no,
your
no,
family,
so BJP talks about zero tolerance. Then let us talk about BJP's corruption and tolerance towards corruption.
Such a
let's not bring past instances and bring Subramaniam Swami.
I think your
Subramaniam
party
Swami
has
is in the habit
no,
of filing
no moral.
Cases. He thinks he is the only
no
crusader of justice
corruption.
In this country. He also has
your
several stigmas on his head. He is also chucked out from Harvard University for speaking whatever that comes to his
you
mind. So let's not talk about the complainant.
I think
let us look at the justice
whole.
Issue.
I
this judgment will be a deterrent. It will be a deterrent. Mr.
G.V.L.
Narasimhan, please keep quiet for a while. Please keep quiet for a while.
Come on, you cannot
don't
speak
interrupt other speakers or other panelists.
Not to be contradicted.
Either
how,
you speak,
kind
I think
moral,
you all are
kind of
forming a habit of speaking when other panelists speak. So please keep quiet. Listen to other people also. and please have the habit of listening to the truth and the facts.
I have to contradict you.
No, it is a matter of record. It's a matter of record when I'm talking about Babu Bokaria. Please come to Gujarat.
Am I talking about Babu Bokaria or am I talking about Jayalalitha?
Leadership.
Zero tolerance.
Am I talking about Jayalalitha or Babu Bhai Bokaria?
Corruption.
Am I talking about
Gandhi Nehru family?
Zero tolerance. Zero tolerance to corruption means you have to make a statement. But the BJP will not make a statement because their statements on corruption is very different. They were double speak. They are very convenient way to speak. Here I am talking about the justice system where this judgment is a welcome judgment.
And all the corruption issues,
cases will definitely look up to this judgment as a precedent. People have still faith in the judiciary. They rush to the court. So Mr. Narasimhan, you do not know what you are talking about.
You have the audacity to speak about corruption. I think it's a matter of a big joke. I think this country, what the country thinks about
no,
the Congress
I think you
party.
Don't use this language.
Can I ask a question to both of you? Now, I'm making an observation. You can both attack me if you want. The points I have just raised make a point. Today, you see, I know what the courts have done. We celebrate what the court. I have only made one point. My first point is that the Congress party, Sonia Gandhi, knew of the serious charges. Right? Sonia Gandhi knew of all the serious charges facing Jayalalitha when she decided to have a tea party with her organized by Subramaniam Swamy, which I think is one of the greatest ironies of our times, which proved that Sonia Gandhi was willing to compromise to any level in order to get her political convenience right. Point number one in the Jayalalitha case. As far as the BJP is concerned, I am just amazed, Mr. Narasimha Rao. I am amazed at the fact that you look so unsure about your position today. You don't know what to say. You don't know what to say, how much to say. You want to be careful. The same kind of conviction you had in the Lalu Prasad case is thoroughly missing.
I think
thoroughly missing in the case of Jayalalitha.
Conviction.
Because you need to keep your political marriage going with the IDMK.
Entire political class. And it's a signal to the Congress party for all the corruption that you have indulged in. The rule of law will catch up with
you. So Narendra Modi speaks about Robert Vadra. Why does Narendra Modi not speak about Jayalalitha? Please tell me. Narendra Modi speaks about Robert Vadra. Why does Narendra Modi not speak about Jayalalitha?
The party does not contest elections in Haryana.
Really? I don't understand this logic.
I hope you know.
Is Robert Vadra contesting
elections in Haryana and Maharashtra?
So is Robert Vadra contesting elections in Haryana?
The Congress party, and that's a relevant
issue. So you are
scams have
okay,
happened
so,
in the state
so
of
you,
Haryana.
You are now trying to defend yourself saying that Narendra Modi does not talk about Jayalalitha because Jayalalitha is from Tamil Nadu. So tell me, did Narendra Modi, when he spoke about Kalmadi, speak only in Maharashtra during the general election? When Narendra Modi spoke about Raja, did he speak only in Tamil Nadu about him?
Was part of a national corruption scandal.
Okay, so that is national corruption. This is so. What is this? What is this? What is regional corruption? No, one second. What is this regional corruption? This is some regional corruption.
Come on, I think you have to grant it to the political parties.
Sir, I am
to decide what issues to raise in which state. I think we will not be. We will not be wise.
So why are you looking? So why are you looking? So why are you looking so unsure, weak, and if I may say, so unsettled? Mr. Narasimha, why are you looking so unsettled? All I am asking you is, why are you looking so unsure on Jayalalitha? You are looking unsettled. Your party does not have a position. You have no conviction. You have no answer. Why does Narendra Modi not talk about Jayalalitha? Simple question. Tell me this. Will Narendra Modi talk about Jayalalitha?
I am my usual.
Will he take on Jayalalitha? Will Amit Shah take on Jayalalitha? Will they talk about Jayalalitha with the same conviction that they talk about Lalu Prasad Yadav or Suresh Kalmadi? Will they do that? And if they won't, then tell me why won't they?
In Tamil Nadu, it will be an issue.
In Tamil Nadu, it won't be. It will be an issue.
Come in Tamil Nadu, it will be. It will
but
be
then
an
you're
issue,
okay, fine. Mr. Rajashekaran, Mr. Prashant, let's go back to them. We have a few minutes left on this debate. Mr. Rajashekaran, Mr. Prashant.
Arnav, can I come in? Arnav.
Yes, bro, Prashant
Arnav,
wants
to. Can I come in for a second?
Yes. Arnav, I want to make.
No, no, one second. Our guests from Chennai want to come in here. Yes, go ahead.
See, I want to make a point here. You are talking about corruption, whereas I want to tell one important point. this case foisted against Ms. Jayalalitha has nothing to do with corruption.
Why? Really? What is it to go with the weather?
She was chief minister for 91 to 96. Let me speak. 91 to 96, she was chief minister, and she was not on the streets of Tamil Nadu. She was an actress. She was earned a lot of money. Her mother was an actress. All this background, she comes into politics. She was with the leader, Mr. MGR, and the legacy of MGR follows her, and she becomes the chief minister. Of course, there are a lot of mistakes she had committed. Later on, she becomes chief minister in 2001 to 2006, and subsequently 2011 to 2014, till date she is chief minister. She has become most popular leader in the whole country, and she has come out with lots of schemes, rolled out best schemes as Amma Canteens and Amma, all in the name of Amma, and the people of Tamil Nadu.
So that money, Amma Canteen, Amma the so-and-so, is not her money, by the way. One second, you can name it after her.
Yes,
it's taxpayers' money.
Even the other parties are ruling. Mr. Kamraj, nobody had the heart to give to the people of the state.
So you are trying to say today that I gave you subsidized food. You are saying today I gave you subsidized food, so turn a blind eye to my corruption?
You are attributing more to my words. I'm just saying she has done so many good things.
What good things?
The question of corruption arises as if others are free from all these corrupt activities.
M.R. Venkatesh wants to counter you. Prashant, I'm going to come back to you.
Corruption.
The question is...
I totally accept that point.
Sir, the question. Sir, it doesn't matter. My simple answer to you, sir. My simple answer to you is 2 crores ends up becoming 60 crores. How does it become? Why are front companies used as a front for the assets? And why do her aides help her accumulate these assets? Right? They are very grave offences.
This is the session scope which has pronounced the order. That is the hierarchy of judiciary.
You know, Mr. Rajashekaran. M.R. Venkatesh will respond to you, please. But in other countries, people lose their jobs as members of parliament.
Please understand, this is not the end of the whole story. The sky is not going to fall down. The High Court is there. The competent authority is the High Court, not Mr. M.R. Venkatesh.
So don't go around saying that there were Amma canteens and Amma food and Amma idlis and Amma this and that. You can do all of that. That's taxpayer money. You're not doing a favor because of it. You're not doing a favor because those days are gone, sir.
I'm just saying, I'm emphasizing this point that she has done good to the people of the state. It doesn't mean she is.
So you are trying to say she's some kind of modern day Robin Hood? You are trying to present some modern day Robin Hood kind of image?
Definitely not. See, there is a High Court where you can appeal by way of criminal appeal, and you definitely will get justice. You give the benefit of doubt to Jayalalitha, and you.
Yeah, but don't play this. Don't play this political vendetta card. M.R. Venkatesh is responding to you, Prashant. I'm going to come back to you. I have only a few minutes left. M.R. Venkatesh. M.R. Venkatesh, the verdict is given by a court of law and not a political party. I just want you to keep it in mind.
Absolutely.
The verdict is not given by a political party. It's given by a court of law.
Absolutely, Arnab, we have to respect it. Number one. Number two, till this minute, the ADMK apologists who are appearing on this channel are not giving a concrete reason, one legal reason why bail should have been given to Madam Jayalalitha today. Three, at this point in time, there is no way through, it's an accountant's delight. This case is an accountant's delight. No way they are able to explain how 2 crores became 64 crores at the end of her tenure in 96. Let me put it clear that ADMK people are substituting hard.
No, I'm not ADMK.
He's saying you're an apologist for the ADMK.
Yeah. And you want to substitute through filibuster all your legal arguments, and you think emotions will carry you through the court. Unfortunately, courts are too wise. They have seen all these things, all these dramas for several decades. They are not going to listen to drama. Please, for heaven's sake, put your legal hat and talk through it, and I'm sure you will get bail. Don't come and say she has run a canteen, so she's entitled for this particular bail. No court is going to listen to
you. You are not the judge. See, it is the Supreme Court who is going to decide the wisdom of the appellate court will decide the bail. And it is not M.R. Venkatesh who is going to decide the bail. And Jayalalitha is not in the first you understand. First, you should understand you are just a political observer.
Mr. Rajshekar, so this kind of emotion is not going to
take
anywhere.
See, the apex court is there.
Nowhere this...
I'm not on the mercy of anybody. I'm just telling you the point. The apex court is the authority to grant bail for Jayalalitha in this case, and it will use its wisdom.
Nobody has, everybody understands it. But this type of shouting will not help you on prime time, Mr. Rajshekar. This time of filibuster will not help you.
Arnab.
The Prashant.
No, it is you. It is not me.
Prashant.
Arnab.
Prashant, please. Yes, Prashant.
I have nothing on this case.
Yeah. No, I have to give credit to BJP because they are not soft on us, because the leader, the superman of Indian politics, Mr. Subramani Swamy, is their face in Tamil Nadu. Okay? He is indomitable and he can do anything he wants. So it is wrong to say that BJP is doing nothing. BJP is soft on ADMK. BJP is never soft on ADMK. No party is ever soft on ADMK. Modi came here. Modi campaigned hard. Modi was not able to do anything against the power of ADMK here. And Subramani Swamy is doing all he can to make sure that Amma remains in jail. So please never ever say that BJP is soft on us. They are not soft on us. But we know the people power will take us.
So people power and all that doesn't work nowadays. So simple point is Prashant. Sir, understand one thing. You see, this whole business, this braggadocio, we've seen it. 10-15 years back, what did Lalu say? Hum sadak pe utar aayenge. Hamare log sadak pe utar aayenge. Hum election jeet jayenge. Kuch nahi hone wala hai. Now you know that under present rules, she's disqualified as a result of a conviction. Listen to me. She can stand disqualified for a period of 10 years as a result of the Supreme Court judgment on convicted MPs and MLAs in June last year. So, you know, I don't know what this whole, we are going to go to the people, we are going to get elected, we are going to come back stronger.
He's a liar talking. He clearly states that it is not done yet. Okay, there is Supreme Court. There are things to be done.
Cynical mindset of the 90s that let the media do what it wants, let there be public opinion, we'll get elected and we give a damn to everything else. You see, that attitude has to change now.
No one will worry about this verdict. No, if Amma did nothing to people, no good to people, none will worry about this verdict.
So you know what, I'm going to ask Subramaniam Swamy to come and debate against you on this subject. Prashant, since you asked for it, I'm going to ask Subramaniam Swamy to come and debate against you if he agrees. Let's talk. Okay, we'll talk about this. We might try and have that on tomorrow. I thank you very much, gentlemen, for joining me on this debate on the News Hour tonight. Thank you.